I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Hey everybody, how you doing? Check it out, I've got a box. Let's see what's inside the box. Ooh. Survivor. Let's see. Green box. Survivor has a little warning label on it. The warning label says, this knife has an extremely sharp edge. Blah, 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 blah. This is the HK-106320 made in China. Let's see. Mmm. Tasty silica gel. Anyway, ordered this off Amazon. They were dirt cheap. I'd seen them before. And I think they were like $7.83 before. Now they're like $4.83. So I didn't buy them back then because I was like, you know. But I decided to go ahead and buy it now. What do we actually have here? This is supposed to be a survival knife. It's a full-tang blade. It means it's one blade all the way across. It's not very long. It's a little tanto style. It says stainless steel USA custom design. And then, what? Oh. Hand forged in China. Alright. Nice little serrated edge here, which will do absolutely nothing. Tuna. Actually doesn't feel too bad. It's got the paracord string on it, which is really just a, this is about, I don't know, this is more like a shoestring than actual paracord. So if you're gonna use something like that, you might as well go ahead and replace it with some real paracord. The actual handle part is pretty small if you've got medium to large size hands, which you do. Overall blade length, I think, is right around 4 inches or so, maybe a little bit longer, about 4.5. That's not too bad. It's not too uncomfortable. I mean, you know, for it is what it is. A little survival knife. It does come with a little fire starter striker thing. Little clasp on the end, lock it down. Little nylon style sheath, which feels kind of cheesy. That's not too bad. Just some vinyl stuff on the inside here, so it doesn't get hung up on your butt loop. Yeah, this is sewed on there. This is the vinyl. Got the vinyl stuff in there. Vinyl stuff on that one. It's not too bad. Overall, it's about 7.5 inches, and see, there's the problem right there. See that? If you push it down too far, that point's coming out. That's a little bit of a problem. But we have a less than $5 survival knife. This would be good to keep in your bag just in case of emergencies. I don't know if I would use this as an everyday carry. Actually, I wouldn't use this as an everyday carry. But if I was traveling out in the woods, or if I had like a bug out bag, or just a kind of a travel bag, I'd probably keep it in the car, maybe in toolbox, glove department, something like that, just in case you need it. This is actually better than nothing. Feels pretty solid. Blade's pretty sharp. It's usable. We're cutting stuff. So there you go. It's a $5 survival knife. Yeah, replace the paracord, use some better paracord. Either reinforce the sheath or get a better sheath. But for a little carry knife, just in case for emergencies, and it's under $5. These things are all over Amazon, man. You can find them. Not bad. And it's got the full tang all the way down. Feels pretty solid. Little cheesy knife. Very cool. Yeah. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.